Bad day as an EOD tech is doing administrative work.
As EOD techs, we work on the ground, integrated with special forces, skydiving and parachuting. We work underwater, clearance of underwater mines. You go down there and you're looking for a mine in the middle of the ocean. Can't really see very well, but it's exciting.
We have the surface IED threat today.
Most of the time, mines are made out of metal, which means they're denser than rocks or sandbars or anything like that. So we use different sensors to try to hone in on that specific shape, specific density, specific signature that a mine is going to give us.
You have just kind of your basic multi-tool. That's kind of like your get out of jail. You have your shears to cut stuff, mine probes. You have to be creative. You're not always going to have what you need on hand. And that's kind of where a big part of our training comes in, is to kind of give you the outside of the box thinking.
This is the Talon. It has four cameras. You can do a lot with the robot. We carry explosive charge with the robot, so we can drop it, end up just blowing it up right there if we want to. Or we can get into more like surgical precision movements, cut wires if we wanted to. Every scenario is different. The coolest part is obviously blowing stuff up.
Just give me a 10-digit grid on where you're blowing it. That way I can respect higher to let them know.
Okay, cool.
My first impression of it was just, that's a lot louder and heavier than I thought it would be. It's not like in the movies.
There's all kinds of explosives. C4, a lot of plastic explosives. Detta sheet, which is just a sheet explosive. We'll spend a week learning how to make homemade explosives to be able to identify them in the field.
In EOD, there's never a black and white answer. It's always what's going to be the safest, what's going to be the best, because this is an inherently risky job.